Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, Writing Practices. Today, we are going to learn how to write an MBA recommendation letter. What is a recommendation letter for MBA program? An MBA recommendation letter is a formal document written by a professional or academic reference, endorsing an individual's qualifications and suitability for admission to a Master of Business Administration or MBA program. This letter typically highlights the candidate's skills, achievements, leadership qualities, and potential for success in business studies and future career endeavors. It provides insights into the candidate's character and capabilities from someone who has closely worked with or supervised them. First of all, you need to write the recommender's information. Yes, write the complete name of the recommender to identify the author. And write also the recommender's professional title to establish credibility. Under it, write the name of the company or organization where the recommender works. Write also the full address of the recommender's workplace. Mention the number, street name, city, state, and zip code. Sure, you can also add contact information like phone number and email address. After that, write the date of the letter when it is written, to establish the timeline of the recommendation. For the next, you can write the recipient's information. Yes, write the name of the office or department. Write also the specific office or department receiving the letter. In this case is admissions office. And write also the program name. The name of the program the candidate is applying is MBA program. Under it, write the name of the institution. In this example is Stanford Graduate School of Business. Don't forget to write also the full address of the institution. Mention the number, street name, city, state, and zip code. And now, write the subject of the letter. You can simply write, recommendation letter for, followed by the name of the person you recommend. After completing all these information, you can open the letter with a formal salutation. Simply write, Dear Sir or Madam, or Dear Admissions Office. In the first paragraph, which is introduction paragraph, you need to write the statement of purpose. Yes, clearly state that you are recommending the candidate for the MBA program. Of course, you need to write the name of the institution as well. And here is how you write it. I am writing to wholeheartedly recommend Emily Johnson for admission to the MBA program at Stanford Graduate School of Business. After that, write the recommender's position and relationship. It is a must that you introduce yourself, your position, and how you know the candidate. Yes, mention also the duration and nature of your relationship. This is the perfect example how you write it. As Director of Operations at Innovative Tech Solutions, I have had the pleasure of working closely with Emily for over 3 years. During which time she consistently demonstrated exceptional skills and an unwavering commitment to excellence. In the second paragraph, this is where you write about candidate's professional skills and achievements paragraph. Yes, you can firstly write key achievements. It is important to highlight specific projects or tasks where the candidate demonstrated outstanding skills. This is a good example how to elaborate this part. Emily has been instrumental in leading our team through several high-stake projects, showcasing not only her outstanding analytical and strategic thinking skills, but also her natural leadership ability. And then, write more about quantifiable results. In this section, you need to provide measurable outcomes. They can be about the percentage increases, cost reductions. The goal is to illustrate the candidate's impact. And here is the example how you write it. For instance, she spearheaded a project that streamlined our project management processes, which resulted in a 30% increase in efficiency and a significant reduction in costs. In the third paragraph, this is the place you write about candidates' interpersonal skills. You can mention the soft skills. Here, describe the candidate's interpersonal and communication skills. For example, you may write something like, What sets Emily apart is not just her technical skills and professional accomplishments, but also her exceptional interpersonal and communication skills. Not only that, mention also leadership and teamwork. It is necessary that you highlight examples of the candidate's ability to lead, foster teamwork, and connect with colleagues at various levels. You may write it this way: she has the rare ability to connect with individuals at all levels, foster teamwork, and motivate her peers towards achieving common goals. Also important, you need to write about their character traits. It means, you need to mention positive traits only. They are such as empathy, ethical standards, and respectability within the organization. And this is how it will look like. Her empathy and ethical standards have made her a respected leader in our organization. In the fourth paragraph, this is where you talk about candidates' learning and growth. At first, you can write about curiosity and learning. In this case, you need to discuss the candidate's enthusiasm for learning and personal growth. And write the relevance to MBA program. Of course, it is a must that you explain how the candidate's desire to learn aligns with the objectives of the MBA program. For example, you can write something like, Emily exhibits a genuine curiosity and a continuous desire to learn and grow, which I believe are critical qualities for success in an MBA program. After that, you can continue by writing the potential contributions. Yes, mention the fresh insights and perspectives the candidate is expected to bring to the program. If you have no idea what to write for this section, you can write something like, she has expressed a deep interest in enhancing her understanding of global business strategies. And I am confident that she will bring fresh insights and a diverse perspective to the classroom. In the fifth paragraph, you can write overall recommendation. It is highly recommended that you reaffirm your strong recommendation for the candidate's admission. Make sure that you write it properly. For example, you may write it like, I have no doubt that Emily Johnson will excel in the MBA program at Stanford Graduate School of Business and make a significant contribution to the academic and social environment at your esteemed institution. After that, write the summary of confidence. It means, you need to summarize your confidence in the candidate's ability to excel and contribute positively to the institution. Sure, you can write something like, she has my highest recommendation for admission to your program. In the fifth paragraph, this is where you write your contact information. Provide your contact details again for any further inquiries. Here, you can write your phone number and email address. This is the example how you write it. Should you require any further information, please do not hesitate to contact me at 555-890-4567 or jonathan.hayes@email.com. In the last paragraph, write an appreciation for the recipient. All formal letters include this part. You can simply write, thank you for considering this recommendation. And finally, you can close the letter with sincerely. Add your signature and write your full name under it. So, that's how you write an MBA recommendation letter step by step. I hope you find this video helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.